Hello, I'm Kevin Green, the editor of Improve Your Course Fishing magazine, and the guy behind me, well, that's Bob Roberts, a regular in the magazine every single month. Now, the water we've come to today is on the Wyreside Lakes fishery in Lancashire, and it's called Sunnyside One Pool. Now, Sunnyside One is famous for its carp. It's got dozens of 20-pounders, several over 30 pounds. That's not what Bob's after today, though. Oh, no. He's got a waggler rod in his hand, and the bait he's got, sweet corn, maggots, casters and hemp. Yep, Bob is after roach. Like many big carp waters, Sunnyside One is home to millions of roach, including some really big ones. So I think what we need to do is find out if Bob's going to catch them.
Well, as Kevin's told you, we're here on Sunnyside One, and I'm having a fabulous day's fishing. The biggest problem I've got today is not getting bites. There are just too many fish in the swim here. It's absolutely paved with roach, and they're at all levels in the water, and they're all different sizes. So I'm just going to run you through the rig that I'm using at the moment. I'm using a very simple Drennan insert crystal waggler, and it's 2.5 AA loading. I've got 2 AAs immediately below the float, which you'll see there is held by a silicon adapter. That enables me, if I want to change the float. If it gets windier, or gets calmer even, I can put a smaller float or a larger float on. Beneath the float, I've got one number four and one stots. I like these stots because they give you a nice, simple, steady flow of your bait through the water. But that one is there just as a locking shot and to give me a depth marker. But if I want, I can drop it down to the bulk shots. Working down the rig, if you come back to mid-water, I have four stots. The number eight stots, all in a row, I can pull them apart. They slide very easily on the line, as you can see, or I can hold them together as one bulk shot. The thing about these, when they hit the water, it's not like a split shot that goes with a big splash. These fall gently on the water. Beneath that, I have a bulk of three stots, then one stot, a tiny dropper stot, and a size 18 hook. And I'm ringing the changes with my bait here. I'm trying single caster, double caster, corn, maggots, all to no avail. Doesn't matter what I put out there, I get bites. So really, the secret to getting through them is not in how I present the rig, but more how I feed. And a little bit of that now will show you how I've been doing that. The main feed I've been using is hemp, caster, maggots and corn. I would prefer just to use one bait. It would make it so simple. But because I've got fish eating bait at different heights in the water, I know that a maggot will fall slower than a caster and the corn and the hemp. So if I spray a small amount of maggots there, it gives something for the smaller fish to compete for higher up in the water. I'm concentrating mainly on the hemp and the caster, and you might think, well, you've not got many casters there if your swim's full of fish. I've actually got several pints in my box. But you see people put casters in water. If you do that, okay, they don't dry off, they don't turn, but these casters are crunchy casters. You see that? They go on the hook better, the hook comes through them better. If I put them in water, they would go soft and you get soggy casters. And you've got to think a bit like food. Would you have a soggy apple or a crunchy apple? So what I do is I just take half a pint of casters out about every hour and just top up the box. I've been putting corn in to no avail really, but everywhere I go fishing elsewhere for roach like corn. If I fish for tench with corn, I know I'll pick up a few decent roach while I'm at it. So I've been putting a little bit of corn down, hoping that the odd big roach, and we saw some last night, will come and have a munch, and maybe later on, we might fluke a big roach. Okay, so back to the fishing. I've put a double caster on the hook for this cast. I've done that because there's so many small fish there, I'm hoping I might be able to just get through, offer them a slightly bigger mouthful. Now, here's a good little tip. When you cast out on the waggler, overcast the spot that you're going to feed, dip the rod, a couple of quick turns to straighten the line, and then lift swiftly and smartly like that. Nice crisp lift, and you will sink the line between the float and the rod tip. Now that means the float is actually stationary. It's not going to be pulled out of line. And look at that, it's nicely settled and gone under, and straight into a fish. You'll get 10 times more bites if you get your presentation correct. And if I didn't sink that line, the float would be pulled by the wind and I'd get less bites.
Well, there you have it. It's all action fishing, a bite a chuck, feeding all the time and catching fish. Now, what would you rather do? Sit there and struggle all autumn and winter while the bites dry up, or actually go to a carp water and do something different to what everyone else is doing? I know what I'd rather do. Catch fish. That's what it's all about, and that's what Bob's shown you. So, you know what to do next? Get to your nearest carp fishery, a specimen carp fishery, book yourself in a swim, and get down there with a waggler rod or a feeder rod and some maggots and casters. There's some great roach fishing to be had. It's brilliant fun.